What's going on, Knicks fans, and welcome to Knicks in Six right here on the MSG Networks YouTube page. My name is Kazim Famuyiwide, and I'm joined by the wonderful, the talented, my good friend, Bill Pito. I'm in the holiday spirit, Bill. How you feeling, bro?
I love the adjectives. I wish everybody described me the way you described me.
You're a wonderful person, and you know what? It's the holiday season, and I feel like now is no better time than ever to talk about six things that the Knicks are giving us, the fans, for the holidays. So let's start it off. I want to start off with number one, the top story, in my opinion. The reports of the demise of Kemba Walker may have been greatly, greatly exaggerated. Everybody under the sun has talked about how much of a pro Kemba has been when he was kind of sent to the bench a little bit unceremoniously. We've seen in so many instances, so many players, especially guys who are as accomplished as Kemba Walker, multiple-time All-Star, I mean, one of the most popular guys in the entire league, really not take it in stride the way he did. But I think you kind of noticed from that first press conference where he said he noticed there's a lot of young kids on his team. They're all watching him. They're all seeing that, hey, this could be you sometimes. And this is the way to kind of approach it. And now, not only did he approach it as a professional off the court, he's showing it on the court. The first two games, he was back in the lineup. He had 28 points against the Celtics, 21 points against the Detroit Pistons as well. And he's looking like he's got a little bit of a burst, man. Like, he may not be the guy who can finish around the rim like he used to back in the day, but that jump shot is still good. He's making plays. He's getting Mitch Robinson involved. I mean, that is one guy we have been dying to see get a little bit more active on the offensive end of the court. And he's been absolutely killing it ever since he's been set back into the starting lineup. So don't throw no dirt on Kemba Walker's grave just yet, Bill. I think he's got a lot more games to put out there.
Yeah, he's alive and kicking. Another gift from my end, Kaz, has been the play of Evan Fournier. Been up and down, but the last three games, 23 against Houston, tied his career high, another 32-point performance against Boston like he had an opening night, and then 22 against the Pistons. Three straight solid games after Fournier had five straight games, Kaz, in single figures. So if the Knicks are going to start getting 20-point nights out of Evan Fournier, that changes the entire dynamic of what is possible for this team. And he's also working really well of late with Julius Randle.
I think my next gift, as the Knicks fandom is concerned, is youth being served, right? Like, it feels like for the past several weeks, due to the COVID outbreak and the Omicron variant, that a lot of youth and a lot of the young players of the New York Knicks are starting to get their opportunity to show what they can really do. And I think the best way you can tell the health of an organization, not for this season, but going forward for seasons 2, 3, and 4 down the line, is how well you're drafting. And every single rookie who has gotten the opportunity to really shine, whether it's their second year players or first year players, they've all shown that they belong in this league, whether it's Immanuel Quickley getting a career high in 3-pointers, Obi Toppin just completely blowing the roof off the Garden every time he's on a fast break. And Quentin Grimes and Deuce McBride, who had two of their best games as professionals when they were thrown into the fire. And I think there's no better way to know where the direction of a franchise is going by looking at their youth and seeing the players that you drafted and seeing where they can go from there. So I think that's another great gift that the Knicks fans can look forward to.
Kaz, the Knicks have also, over the last handful of years, developed Mitchell Robinson, and a gift from him of late, been playing really well. Of course, he had the injury problems, had a hard time in preseason getting into shape. Looked like for a lot of the early season, he's been out of shape, but boy, season high 17 against the Rockets, matched with 17 against the Pistons. So he's hit his season high in two of the last three games. Really active, and I think really important to point out, if he is on his game and protecting the rim like Tom Thibodeau likes, that could really make up for defensive deficiencies elsewhere on the court. So if he's doing his thing, maybe that could offset Kemba Walker's struggle at times on defense, and that could be a huge positive going forward.
Totally agree with that. And another gift that I want to say, somebody who's, I feel like, been an unsung hero to not just the Knicks, but to any team he's ever been on, is Taj Gibson. Like, he's a guy who's just been an absolute linchpin in the post. There's been so many injuries, like you mentioned, with Mitchell Robinson, Nerlens Noel. There's been a lot of flux within that front court position. Jericho Sims being in and out from the G League. But Taj Gibson, every time he gets on the court, every time he plays with Derrick Rose in that you know, pick and roll, he's even starting to hit threes now. He's even starting to stretch the floor a little bit. So, I mean, Taj Gibson, he's been Mr. Reliable, man. He's not going to have numbers that jump out the page when it comes to final stats, but he's been somebody that's been completely invaluable to the Knicks' front court depth and issues.
Had to play some three as well, Taj Gibson. I mean, he's at the threes, at the four, he's at the five. He's everywhere. My last gift, and it sets us up going into the new year, the schedule. Kaz, you look at the schedule between now and about January the 20th, it's about a 15-game stretch against teams that are either at 500 or below 500. To me, this is a key sequence to the Knicks schedule. Hopefully guys will be coming back, getting healthy, and then you have these winnable games. And the way the Eastern Conference is set up with the parity and the tightness of the standings, it's not going to take much for the Knicks to move up significantly.
It's a long season, and there's a lot of basketball to be played. New York Knicks fans, stay tuned right here on MSG all season long to catch your New York Knicks. This has been Knicks in Six. That is the wonderful Bill Pito. My name is Kazim Famuyiwa, and we will see you around, City. Take it easy.
Happy holidays, everybody.
Happy holidays.